We'll continue with our last session. Here in our last class, we have created this Maven project, added the test ng dependency, not this project, this one, Rakesh test ng. Okay, and then here we have created one test case of new signup and login. Now today I will be discussing the concept of data provider annotation. Now, what does this data provider annotation do? This data provider annotation provides the data to the test method. Okay, say I want to pass user ID and password. As a parameter to this test method. So what I can do, I can use this data provider annotation to pass the data to this test method. @ data provider is an annotation, and the method name can be any name, say login data, but the method return type must always be two-dimensional array. Whenever we are using data provider annotation, the method return type must always be two-dimensional array, because it returns the data to the test method in array format. So let us write AA BB. So what I want this AA as a user ID and A as a password to be passed to this test method. Then again, second row, first data BB as ID and B as password. So it will pass this data to this particular test method. For that, what we have to do with @ test method, I have to write data provider is equals to double quotes and the name of the method. Like this. I will pass only the name of the method, not circular bracket. Only the name. So with @ test method, I will be using data provider D is small and P is capital, it is case sensitive. Is equal to name of the data, and it will just pass the data to the test method AA and A, BB and B. Every time it passes the data to the test method as a parameter value, test method is called again and again. So it means test method will be called two times, one for this data and another time for this data. Similarly, let us assume that here in new signup also, I want to pass some data, say a string name or a string age. A string marks. Now, a string can store everything. Numeric value can be stored in a string. Decimal value can be stored in a string. And later on, we can typecast from a string to int or a string to the decimal, because here it is returning object type of the data. So a object means which does not have any type. So here, object type of the data will be automatically taking it as a string type of the data, and then we can later on convert it according to our requirement. So now here we are taking three inputs, 1, 2, 3. It's not compulsory that we have to take only two, three inputs. So again, I can use one more data provider annotation like this, @ data provider, and then public return type should be two dimension array object and any name. And inside this method, you have to initialize the array and return it. Now here I want to add, say, Ram, then age, then marks. This is one row, three columns, another row, three columns, and if you want to make another row, now this data, it will pass to the method, but for that we have to again write data provider. And the name of the method, then only it will pass the data. Name of the method. So at the rate data provider passes the data to the test method. Here three values it will pass one by one. So let us run it. Before running it, let us print this value so that you come to know that it is passing the value. So I'll just add it to the message. Okay, so let us run this again. Okay, so we have created this testng.xml in our last session, in which we have added these classes. So we'll execute this testng.xml file. If you see here, sign up test is called, and with sign up test the data is passed, and we are passing the data three times, so it is calling this sign up test three times. For every data it passes to the test method, the test method is called again and again, and with @test method, before method and after method is called again and again. Okay. Similarly, login test, two data, it is passing to the test method, and two times it is calling the @test method. Login test, login test. But now, actually we take the data from the Excel. Okay. So let us make one more package like we have done before. Let us make one more package by the name of Excel. Okay. And in Excel, let us take one Excel sheet, say student here. And in student, I have this UID and PWD. Say, and again, I will say make one more sheet, say name, age, marks. So I have sheet 2 with UID PWD, sheet 3 with name, age, marks. Again, I will copy this Excel file from here and keep it inside my project. Okay. Now, to add the data from the Excel, I need to add this dependency, PUI dependency in my project. So that I will take my from older project. From here, Apache PUI I can take. And I will add it to my okay. So now what we have done, we have added the Excel file, we have added the dependency in my project. Now I will go to my page.java. And here I will create, like before we have done, I will create global variables public connection con is equals to null. Connection is coming from SQL package. java.sql.connection. I will create a statement object also. java.sql. So we have created these global variables. Then I will go to make workbook connection. And similarly, like I was taking parameters, so I will use the parameters later on. I will just add the connection code over here. So that connection code I can take from my project, because we have already discussed these things. So I'm just copying it from my other project. Okay. Class.forName is used to register the driver. Workbook path I am taking. So in, I will hard code it over here because I am not taking the parameter right now. So I will hard code it for that is SRC test Java Excel, and inside Excel I have a file by the name of student.xls. So I'll hard go up because I'm not taking the parameter right now. So I will just write student.xlsx. Then workbook path connected to a create statement, select a star from say again I'm not taking the parameter, so hence I will write select star from sheet 2. Okay, so select star from sheet 2. So what it will do, it will select the data from sheet 2 and store it in a result set object. Here result set I have taken a global variable. Now this is all we have to do in page.java. So we have written this code, and if you want to close it, then you can also close it on dot commit on dot close like this. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to come to this login data, and in this login data we have to read this data from the Excel. So I will remove this thing. And now first of all, I will check whether result set is null or not null. So first of all, I will throw the exception. If result set is not equal to null, result set we have taken, so it is inherited result set. When we extend page, so in page we have already defined result set RS, and result set is storing the information select star from sheet 2. So we are checking whether result set is empty or not empty. So if result set is not null, it means it is not empty, then we have to get the data from the result set and store it in a array, because it always returns the data in an array format. So again I will copy the code from my project and then I will explain you. This is a standard code which you have to just do copy and paste, nothing else. Okay, this is a standard code which you have to do copy and paste, but you have to understand what we have written. First of all, we have initialized the array. That is all we have done in core Java. We have initialized the array as an empty array. Now to initialize the array, I have to know how many rows are there, how many columns are there. तो नाउ इन रिजल्ट सेट देर इज वन मेथड कॉल्ड गेट मेटा डाटा विच रिटर्न्स द रेफरेंस ऑफ रिजल्ट सेट मेटा डाटा. रिजल्ट सेट मेटा डाटा इज अ इंटरफेस इन एसक्यूएल पैकेज विच गिव्स द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द टेबल. तो व्हेन आई यूज दिस मेथड गेट कॉलम काउंट आई विल गेट द नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स. लाइक इन एक्सेल देर कैन बी टू कॉलम्स, देर कैन बी थ्री कॉलम्स, देर कैन बी फोर कॉलम्स. तो इन रिजल्ट सेट व्हाट वी आर स्टोरिंग, हाउ मेनी कॉलम्स वी आर स्टोरिंग, आई विल गेट दैट पर्टिकुलर इंफॉर्मेशन. गेट कॉलम काउंट, देन आर एस डॉट लास्ट विल प्लेस द रिकॉर्ड ऑन अ लास्ट रिकॉर्ड एंड गेट रो will get the position of the last record. With that I will come to know how many rows are there in a result set. So basically if result set is not null, it means we are storing the data in a result set, so we are getting the number of rows and number of columns is stored in a result set. That this is a standard thing. Get column count will return the column count, and then rs.last rs.getRow will get the column count. Then because my result set is on last record, I have to reset it back to the before first, because when I run the program after RS last record there is no record, so I will not get anything. So because I have placed the pointer on the last record, I have to reset it back to the before first. And now we know the column count and row count. So we have initialized this empty array as new object, number of rows and number of the column, size of the array. So we have done in our core Java, when we initialize the two dimension array, we have to specify the row count and the column count. So we have specified the size of the array, how many rows it will take and how many columns it will take. Now again, nested loop. If you remember, we have done this example in two-dimension array in which we are asking from the user how many rows you want, how many columns you want, and then I was adding the data to the array. Same example. So that's why we have done core Java before. Okay. So now again nested loop. So we have started from row number 1 until row plus plus until there are rows less than equal to. So this is a loop for the row, and again nested column number 1 until there are columns, column plus plus. So as already discussed, first of all row number will be 1 and internal loop will keep on incrementing for the column. So row will remain 1, column will keep on incrementing, and when the column increments is over, then only it will go above and increment row plus plus and it will become 2. And then again it will go inside it for row number 2. So same thing we have done, that is one more method, rs.absolute row number. So it will point to the row, so it will remain 1, and then rs.get object column number 1, column number 2, column number 3. So it will, this column number will keep on incrementing, but this will remain 1. So it will get all the columns for row number 1, all the data. Then again it will go up row plus plus 2, here 2 will come, so it will point to the row number 2, and then column number 1, column number 2, column number 3, all the columns of row number 2. So in that way it will get the data I am storing in an object. Okay. So object means anything can be stored in object type of the data. Okay. Whether it is decimal or whether it is int or whether it is a string, object can store any kind of data. So get object, instead of writing get a string, because we do not know, in Excel there can be decimal value, in Excel there can be numeric value. So but I do not know the type, so I'm taking it as an object. So get object will take all things, whether it is number, whether it is integer, whether it is decimal, it will take all things and store it in an object type of the data. Now this data which I am getting from the Excel I want to add it to this array. This array is an empty array. This is empty array. So I have to add the value to this array. So again, I am using this array, data array, and adding this data to this array, adding table data in array. So this is a basically standard program in which we are just checking the number of rows and columns, initializing the array, and then getting the values from the array, getting the values from the Excel one by one and adding it back to the array and return data. Okay, return data will return the data. Let us check the brackets first. For, then this for, then is if, and then this bracket, and I think one bracket is extra. Okay, save. So in that way, what we are doing, we are passing the value to this method by using data provider annotation, and this data provider annotation is reading the data from the array and adding it to the array and returning the data. Data means two dimension array. So let us run it. So if you see here, login test. Harry, login test, Tom, you see, login test, Sam. So here login test is calling, this though we are not taking from the Excel right now. So sign up test is not taking the data from the Excel. Here, sign up test I have written simple, but here, sign up test is taking the data from simple like this, but here in login test, login data, it is taking the data from the Excel. So here I am checking the login data only. So login data, it is taking Sam, Tom, and Harry. So let us check from the Excel. Sheet number 2, Sam, Tom, Harry. In that way, it is taking data. Say if I want to take this data also, this data. So, abhi to because I am hard coding it. So, I will comment this login test. How do you comment the login test? If you write \, with @test method, then this test method will not be called. It is commented. And when this @test method will not be called, this data provider method will also be not called. So if you want to like just comment that I do not want to run this test, just write \ before @test. Okay. When you write \ before @test, then this method will not execute. And when this method will not execute, this method will also not execute. Okay. So now I am just commenting the login test, and instead of that, now I am coming back to the sign up test. Yeah. In sign up test, throws exception, same thing. Just copy and paste this code. You have to just copy and paste, nothing to do. Understand? And otherwise, just this is a standard program. Okay. Now it will add the data from the Excel sheet and pass it to the this method, sign up test, sign up data. But before that, again, I will go to page.java, and instead of sheet 2, data, this workbook is same, but instead of sheet 2, now it is sheet number 3 from which I am getting the data in result set. So you have to change the workbook name from where you are fetching the data, and you have to change the sheet name. Like now I am fetching the data from sheet number 3, so it will fetch the data from sheet number 3 and store it in this result set object, and then when I will run, then it will get the column count, row count for this result set. Okay. So let us run it again. One failure. It is taking mismatch exception it is giving. Okay, let us do one thing. Object it is taking. Okay, I will just do one thing. I will later on I will make it as an integer, but right now I will just make it as a string only. I will check it, what is the issue. It is giving me the error mismatch. I will check it and rectify and check the issue, what is the issue coming. But right now, I will just make it as a string only. Now it is again taking 3 data from the Excel, like we have taken like this. Okay, so it means you can use this data pointer annotation and you can read the data and pass it to the method in that way. Now one more thing in this. Okay, one more thing in this, that you are passing the data to the test method from the data pointer annotation. But if you want to pass the data to this before and after method, how will you pass the data? Like here, when I was writing this page.java, I was using @before method. So @before method will also take some input, like a string browser, a string URL, it is also taking. So, but data pointer annotation is used only with @test. it cannot be used with at the rate before or after method. And data pointer annotation is used to pass multiple data. Here I want to pass the multiple data. But here when we are opening closing browser, we are not passing multiple values, but these methods can be parameterized method also. So now how to pass the values to these methods? For that we use another annotation called @ parameters within circular brackets, then within curly brackets variable name like browser, then comma, then variable name URL. So we can use two annotation, @ before method and before @ we write @ parameters if the method is a parameterized method. Import org test ng annotations. Similarly, so let us just print it. Similarly, say make workbook connection. I was hard coding it, but now I want to take it as a parameter. So I just write a string, say workbook name, comma, a string sheet name, for example. So now I'm taking two parameters, workbook name, sheet name, and instead of hard coding, I can replace it with plus workbook name and here from sheet name in that way. So right, again it is taking two parameters, workbook name and sheet name. Workbook name we have replaced over here, sheet name. So when we are using the parameterized method in @ before, then we have to use @ parameters with it. Variable name. And sheet name like this. Workbook name, sheet name. Again, say I want to generate log and report. Again, where to generate log and report? Say I want to create some folder over here and I want to store log and report. So I also give the name of the log and report. So again, say I give the name as a string file name. So let us give the name as file name. File name. So whatever the parameters if you are taking, you have to write @ parameters with it. अरे रिंकू का मैसेज आ गया, चेक करा क्या? 11 बजने, जरा कर लो एक बार, पूछ लो कहाँ है, ठीक है? और नाउ ओके, तो नाउ वी अगेन आल्सो राइट हियर आल्सो सो दैट यू कम टू नो So now what we am trying to tell you that in case of @test method, you can read the data from the Excel or directly by using this @data parameter annotation that we have already explained. But if you want to pass the data to the methods which has an annotation @before class, before method, before test, then in that case you have to use @ parameters with it. And now, but how to pass the values, from where to pass the values, for that we will be using testng.xml. this, so we have to pass the values to this @ parameters from this file testng.xml. so here before the classes I will write one tag, that is parameter tag. So now in parameter name I have to give this name which I have given over here. Parameter name is equals to browser and value Chrome. So it will pass this value Chrome to this browser. So it will map this browser and pass the value from testng.xml browser. Then again parameter name is equals to, second one is URL. So you have to write parameter again and again for every URL. Say http www.xyz.com/log. That means you are passing the browser URL. Parameter name URL, value is equal to, it will pass the value. Then again parameter, next is this one, workbook name. And the value is student.xls. What is the parameter name again? Sheet name. And it is sheet 3. So I was passing. So now we are passing from here. And then, so here it is compulsory to pass all the parameter value. If you are not passing all the parameter value, it will give you the error. Now this one important thing you have to understand, this क्लासेस, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, टू इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वेरी केयरफुली. दीज क्लासेस आर हैविंग टू क्लासेस, वन इज एडमिन टेस्ट एंड अदर इज शॉप टेस्ट. तो इट मीन्स वेन आई एम रनिंग दिस प्रोग्राम, तो आई हैव शोन यू, वेन आई रन दिस एडमिन टेस्ट, ऑल द बिफोर मैथड एंड आफ्टर मैथड विल बी कॉल्ड फॉर दीज टू टेस्ट. बिफोर मैथड, आफ्टर मैथड, बिफोर क्लास, आफ्टर क्लास, बिफोर टेस्ट, आफ्टर टेस्ट. एंड सिमिलरली फॉर शॉप टेस्ट ऑल्सो, वेन आई एम राइटिंग एग्जीक्यूटिंग दीज टू टेस्ट, अगेन बिफोर मैथड, आफ्टर मैथड विल बी कॉल्ड, बिफोर क्लास, आफ्टर क्लास विल बी कॉल्ड. नाउ वट विल हैपन, बिकॉज we have taken all two classes together, this class and this class together, so it will take the same parameters for this class as well as this class, it will take the same parameters, but maybe in shop test the url is changing, url is changing to some another, say login ki jagah it will be say shop. In shop test maybe you are using, in shop test maybe you are using some another Excel file, but here hello but are you rolling, hello, yes, but here it we want different input for these two classes. That is the first problem. And second problem is that in this admin test I have written two @ test together, and when I have written two @ test together, and if I pass the value to this admin test, हाँ बोला लो बोल रहे हैं, लेकिन अभी थोड़ा सा भैया लेट आना, 1 बजे तक आना, ठीक है. तो नाउ हियर इन दिस एडमिन टेस्ट व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल पास द सेम वैल्यू फॉर दीज टू टेस्ट, इट विल पास द सेम वैल्यू फॉर दीज टू टेस्ट, बट वी नीड डिफरेंट इनपुट फॉर दिस, वी वांट अदर शीट नेम, वी वांट अदर शीट नेम. So as I told you in before, that is for every class there should be different @ test method. It is better approach. So let us again do that particular thing. I will right click on this @ test, again create a new test ng class. Say I give the name as login test, finish, and I will copy the login test data, this one, okay, I will take it from here, keep it over here. Separated. Okay. Now it is having only one test method, @ test method. It is having only one test method and the data provider for that particular test method. It is having one test method only. Okay. And the data provider for the test method. Similarly, say in swap test, again I will create one more test ng class. See, I give the name as payment test, and from swap I will remove this So I have now separated all the tests at the rate test. For every test we have created the separate class. Now what is the use? The use is from here classes. If it is a group of the class, that is I want to pass the common parameters to both the classes and they are linked with each other like that, then so it is okay. Otherwise what I can do, I can give the name of the test as sign in test, and then again I will copy this test up to here, make one more test and say I give the name as login test, and I will remove this admin test is having the sign up test method. Okay, and I will remove this one swap test from here. Okay. So now it is having only one class, only one class, and here again in login test I will keep one class, that is login test. Login test. Again, I will create one more test, copy it, paste it. Say I will give it name as swap test. And here again, I will change the name of the class as swap test, and again say I will give the name payment test. Change the name of the file over here. So if you see what we have done in the suit tag only, starting of the suit, ending of the suit, I think some mistake is there, just a second. Okay. I will recheck it because I think some mistake is there. No problem, I'll check it again. So let us check it again. Inside the suit, starting of the suit, ending of the suit. Okay, we are having different test. This is starting of the test and ending of the test. And in this test, we have added this one class, admin test. Okay. All the parameters which we are passing is for this admin test. That is URL login. sign up. Now I want to pass the URL as say home. Home. Like this. Home. Student.xls sheet number 3. And here I want to generate the report by the name of say sign in report. Classes, end of the classes, end of the test. End of the test. Again, I have created one more test by the name of login test. Here I want to open the URL login. I want to connect to the workbook. And here I want to connect to the workbook sheet number 2, not sheet number 3. So different data. And I want to generate the report by the name of login report, not sign up report. So we have separated it. Then classes, class, login test, classes ka classes khatam hua, test ka test khatam hua. Okay, this is another test. Then another test. Another test we have started, test. I think we have not ended this test. That is copy paste problem. So I will end the classes. The classes start, classes should end, classes, and test start, test should end. Okay. Another test by the name of shop test. Here say I want to change the URL to shop. Okay. So here so there is no data provider annotation given, but because we have given the parameter over there, so we have to pass the parameter. It is compulsory to pass the parameter. Okay. So let us give the sheet 4 or 3 only. And here I want to generate the report by the name of say shop report. Okay. Now payment same. I want to go to the link payment. This information we will change according to this payment if they are it. Otherwise, we'll keep on like and but we have to compulsory pass some data. We cannot keep it as a blank. So why we have separated each test? We have separated each test so that we can pass the different parameter value to each test. Otherwise, if in a classes we make a group of the classes, then also it is right. But what will happen for both the classes, it will send the same parameter value. So that's why we have separated it. Let us run it again to check it. Okay. We have to remove this thing. Depends upon. Data provider priority admin test. Okay, it is okay. Login test. Data provider priority. Login data, login test, then shop test, okay, payment test. We have to remove this depends upon, because depends upon will work when the methods are together. Here methods are not together, so we have to remove this depends upon. Now you can check here. First of all, before test method is called for first test. And what it is doing, it is generating the report by the name of sign in report. And it is making the connection with student.xls. And here it is opening this URL home and it is passing this sign up test data. User ID password from the Excel. Again, user ID password from the Excel. User ID password from the Excel. Okay, and then it is before method and after method. Before class, before test, and after all the test is executed here, after class is called, you see, for the first class, after class is called and after test is also called. So it means this is before test and this is after test. This is first test, which is admin test, sign up test. Then again, before test method is called for the next test method. And here, now it is generating the report by the name of login report. Here it was generating the report by sign up report. Here the parameter value is changed. Again, it is making the connection with this, but now it is connecting to the sheet number 2. Here it was connecting to sheet number 3. Here it is connecting to sheet number 2. Sam Sam, Tom Tom, Harry Harry. So different parameters. Again, before test, before class, and then after class, and after test, second test is executed. And similarly, you can check over here for the shop report. Before test, before class, URL opening shop, and then after that payment method is called here. Okay. Okay. So in that way, we can separate the test, and by separating, this is a, I already told you demonstrative example. So we'll show that thing in our real-time example also, when we will writing actually with the Selenium. But objective is to tell you that we can also separate the tests, and by separating the test, we can pass the different parameters to the test method. That is the objective of showing this particular example. Chrome payment is payment report, payment test, payment test, payment test. Okay. Last thing. Say when I am writing many things in testng.xml, all the things will get executed. All the tests will get executed. Maybe I want only this sign up test and login test to execute. I do not want this shop test and payment test to execute. Then how to skip the test? That is another thing. For that, we again go to our before test method. And in before test method, I will pass one more parameter, string key. And because I'm taking two parameters, I will pass key, file name and key. And in key, we will be passing the value true or false. I will check if so what we have done, this is the first method which is called in the life cycle. This is the first method which is called. तो हेयर वी हैव टेकन द की, ट्रू और फॉल्स. तो व्हाट वी हैव, बूलियन इज अ रैपर क्लास, लाइक इंट की इंटीजर होती है वैसे बूलियन, रैपर क्लास इज बूलियन, एंड लाइक पार्स इंट, पार्स बूलियन विल कन्वर्ट दिस स्ट्रिंग टू द बूलियन वैल्यू. एंड नॉट, इफ नॉट ट्रू देन इट विल स्किप द टेस्ट फ्रॉम हेयर ओनली. इफ नॉट ट्रू, अगर यहां पर ट्रू नहीं आता, इफ नॉट ट्रू, दिस इज अ नॉट, इफ नॉट ट्रू थ्रो न्यू एक्सेप्शन, तो इट विल थ्रो द एक्सेप्शन एंड इट विल स्किप द टेस्ट फ्रॉम हेयर ओनली, नो अदर मेथड विल बी कॉल्ड, अदरवाइज यू कैन एग्जीक्यूट योर टेस्ट. ओके, तो नाउ इन अवर टेस्ट एंजिन डॉट एक्सएमएल आई हैव टू पास दिस की वैल्यू ऑल्सो. तो अगेन आई विल राइट फ्रॉम हेयर पैरामीटर, नेम इज इक्वल्स टू की एंड से वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू ट्रू. आई वॉन्ट टू रन इट. Say I do not want to run login test. Say for example I do not want to run login test. So again I will write value. I will write false. False means I do not want to run it. So it will be skipped. Say again, shop test I want to execute. And say, I do not want to run payment. Only the demonstration basically to understand. If I run this again, so before you see, all the tests were executing. Okay, all the tests were executing, and we were getting this report in front of you. Okay, but now what I will do? Again, run it. So you see from here which method is called, sign in method is called sign up test, then shop method is called from here. Okay, so sign up test method and shop method is called, and what are skipped, these are skipped. These are test method which are skipped. So in that way you can write your suit file, and from suit file you can pass the data to the method and also skip it. And to pass the data from the Excel in the test method, use the data provider annotation. Okay, so I will keep up to here. So if any doubt you can ask, otherwise I will share this video.